Okay, I just realized that the sound was off, so it doesn't matter. I'm gonna start from here with the sound. So I just explaining right now very quick. What I have here, I have a codec IC. When you are going to do this, this is iPhone 7 Plus. You are going to do it if the phone is not booting correctly. Okay, if you don't have any sound, if the touch is, it get like, you will see that it's very slow when you touch the screen. You may have no voice memos, okay? So, no me di cuenta que tenía el sonido apagado y estoy empezando desde aquí con el audio. Este es un iPhone 7 Plus que tiene problemas de audio, pero está el problema de estas líneas. Cuando usted tiene problema con este chip, no simplemente le va a dar problema de audio. Usted puede tener que se le congele el touch. Puede tener el teléfono se le queda en el Apple logo, o el teléfono enciende pero se demora en encender. Some people ask me why I do 4 jumpers. Okay. I do 4 jumpers because by experience I have noticed if the impact is very hard or they bend the phone too much, those 4 traces are going to get disconnected. Okay? And you are going to have a future issue. Okay? We have 2 lines. These lines are going to the, these lines, they're going to directly to the TriStar. These are the both positive and negative, both data positive and negative. Okay, so that's why I also prefer just to do it. Another thing, if, let's say in this case, as you notice, the pads are perfectly. When this happens, what I do is I never install the chip again. Okay, I put a new chip. Como ven, cuando yo limpié, no, los traces no se vinieron. Todos los pads están perfectos. Cuando eso sucede, yo nunca instalo el mismo chip, porque generalmente el problema va a ser el chip. Okay, ya no sería un problema del pad. No está desconectado. Every time that I see that there's no traces or pad missing after I clean it, okay, I go straight and I change the chip. I don't use the same chip, okay, because that's telling me that if all the pads are perfect, but we still have no audio, that means the chip is the one by itself is going to be damaged. Okay. Sorry, I didn't realize that on the beginning I didn't have the audio. Every time that I'm going to start video, I always test it. But I start doing something else, and I always make mistakes. But we do our best here. So now we are going to start a new chip. Just put the coating. Okay, and we okay. This is the old one, we put it here. And where do I put the new one? Where did I put the new order? Okay, we're gonna get another one. Take a picture here. Okay. I mean, get another one because I don't know where do I put this chip. Oh, that's the used one. No sé qué hice el chip. El nuevo que iba a poner, vamos a entonces a sacar otro aquí. Imagine, this is having the table clean and organized. And I don't remember if I took this out. Maybe I didn't take it out from the back. No, I think I didn't. Imagínense, esto es teniendo la mesa organizada. No, pero creo que no. Ahora pensándolo bien, creo que nunca lo saqué de la bolsa. I don't know. Okay, so now we are going to install a new one. Vamos a instalar el nuevo. Siempre me gusta precalentar el board antes de poner flux. I always like to preheat the board before adding the flux. So now we are just going to, I always like to hold it on place. You don't have to, but I'm used to do it like that. But if you don't want to hold it, you don't hold it. Okay. Yo estoy acostumbrado a aguantarlo con las pinzas. Pero no significa que tiene que hacerlo de esa manera. Simplemente yo me acostumbré a hacerlo de esa manera. Y pues ya siempre lo hago de esa manera. Lo aguantamos un poco. Vamos a esperar hasta que se derrita. It's going to get in place by itself, right there. You will see now. Touch it a little bit. And if you want, you can put this on place. That's it. Le da un toquecito, como ve. Y de esa misma manera movimos los capacitores, solo para devolverlos. Okay. Tienen que tener cuidado, atrás de esto está el baseband cubierto con bastante coating. Si lo recalientan mucho, van a dañar la señal. You have to be very careful with the not putting too much heat, because otherwise you will damage the signal. Always put fresh air. That's how I clean my boards, all my boards, alcohol and fresh air. Right now, just gonna put the fresh air to cool down faster. Yo siempre limpio todos mis boards con alcohol y aire a presión. Para mí, una de las herramientas primordiales es el compresor. Siempre he usado compresor. Primero usé un compresor bien pequeñito, pero era un compresor. Y tantas veces que encendía el compresor que al final se dañó. Era un, creo que eran 5 galones, algo así. Ahora tengo un compresor grande. For me, the compressor, the air compressor is one of the most important tools in my case, because I like to clean everything by pressure air and alcohol. My first compressor was like, I think was 2 gallons or 5 gallons, I don't remember exactly, and it get used to be very loud, but it get damaged very quick. So now I have a big compressor. So now we're going to see if this works. Vamos a ver si trabaja. Okay, no teníamos notas. Las notas voice memo no funcionaba. Continue. No. Hello, 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 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 probando. Hello, hello, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay. So now edit record. Okay. ¿Vieron? ¿Está funcionando? Ok. So, de esta manera hemos arreglado este problema. Disculpen el video, al principio no tenía audio. Lo voy a mandar así mismo. No me gusta editar video porque me toma demasiado tiempo. Para recopilar, iPhone 7, 7 Plus, sin audio, se queda en la manzana. O se demora mucho tiempo en encender, tiene el touch, es bastante lento, no sirve el voice memo. Eso, una de las razones que puede ser eso, estamos generalmente enfocándonos en el codec IC, ¿ok? So esto fue lo que hicimos en este momento. Este teléfono no tenía audio, era el único problema, encendía sin problema y todo. Basically, iPhone 7, 7 Plus, if you have no audio, no voice memo, boot looping, it's stuck on the Apple logo, or sometimes takes longer to turn on, you will notice sometimes the touch is very, very slow. So that's going to, most of the time, we are going to have issue with the codec IC. As you notice, the paths were perfect. The traces are perfect. There was no path missing. So what I did, I replaced the chip. This chip was damaged, okay? As soon that I realized that I have all the paths and the traces, that means the chip is going to be damaged, okay? Most of the time. Yo inmediatamente, recuerden, cuando veo que el trace está bien, que los pares están bien, ya, directamente no hago un revolving, directamente le cambio el chip. Solamente hago un revolving si le hace falta el trace o el pad. De otra manera, simplemente cambio el chip. ¿Ok? Gracias por mirarnos y hasta la próxima. Thank you for watching. See you next time.